Welcome to myprojectbuzzard.com.
Now we are going to discuss about the product deep representation based feature extraction and recovering for finger wing verification. Now we are going to discuss about the abstract for the process. In this process, a personal verification method using finger wing is presented. Finger wing can be considered more secured compared to the other biometric systems and the other hands-based biometric terrains such as fingerprint and palm print because the features are inside the human body. Because in this finger wing verification system, the finger veins are inside the human body, so it is more secured than the other techniques. In the proposed method, a new texture descriptor called local binary pattern, that is the LLBP, is utilized as feature extraction technique. The neighborhood shape in LBP is the straight line, unlike a local binary pattern, which is the square shape. The experimental result shows the proposed method using LLBP has better performance than the previous method using LBP. Hence, this process is more reliable and the more efficient than the other verification systems like fingerprint and palm print. Hence, here the feature extraction is well stable, hence the classification rate is more than the other process. And also the one more thing is the finger vein segmentation. In this process is well reliable for the finger vein segmentation for the dataset images, and then the accuracy will be improved. Now we are going to discuss about the flow diagram for the process. This is the overall flow structure for the process. At first, the input finger vein image is taken from the dataset. The dataset is the folder which consists of the several input images. Take any one image from the dataset. After getting the image from the dataset, the pre-processing is carried out. In this pre-processing steps, we have the two steps. First one is the image resize, then the second one is the image noise filtering. In the image resize, if we give any size of input image, the image is resized into the aspect ratios. After the image resize, noise filtering is carried out by using the Gaussian filter method. After eliminating the noise from the image, the segmentation is carried out. For the segmentation process, the morphological technique is applied for the segmentation. Hence, after the segmentation, the vein region is extracted and the other backgrounds will be eliminated. After the extraction of the vein region, the feature extraction is carried out. Feature extraction is the process of reducing the size of the image as well as the extracting the key points from the image, that is the data key point from the image. So here we use the LBP method to extract the feature points. After extracting the feature points, the classification is done to classify whether the input is affected or not. So here we use the KNN classification method to classify the whether the input is normal or abnormal. For the classification step, we have to give the three things as input. First one is the test feature, then second one is the train feature, then the third one is the target. The test feature represents the feature of the input image and the train feature represents the feature of the dataset images. Then the target represents the whether the input is normal or abnormal. After the classification process, the performance measured is carried out. For the performance measures, first of all, we took the accuracy, sensitivity, Jaccard coefficient, then the error rate for the estimations. After that, we took the Kappa coefficient, Dice coefficient, true positive and true true negative values. Then these are values are to justify whether the process is efficient or not. Now we are going to discuss about the initial running procedure for the process. At first, open the MATLAB 2013 and change the current directory. Now right click in the main file.m file, then select the option run. Now we can see the dataset name as folder datasets. Now open the folder datasets and select any one image from the dataset folder and click the button open. After clicking the button open, the selected file was executed automatically. The output results will be shown one by one. Now we discuss the result one by one. At first, the input image which we have selected is shown in the figure 1 with the title input image. After getting the input image from the dataset, the pre-processing is carried out by using the Gaussian filter method. The Gaussian filter method is applied to remove the white noise from the image, and then the enhanced image is shown in the figure 2. Then after applying the Gaussian filter, the image resize is carried out. Image resize is nothing but the image is resized into a particular aspect ratios. For example, if the input image is in the size of 100x100, means the resized image will be shown in the size of 256x256. After the image resize process, the image enhancement will be carried out. So here the image enhancement, the input image is converted into the grayscale format. If the input image is the RGB channel, means the conversion will be done to convert the RGB channels into the grayscale. After the grayscale conversion, the optimized result is shown. So in this optimized result and as well as the enhanced results, the vein region will be enhanced and the other regions will be considered as a background. So the vein region is enhanced well and then shown in this two image. Now the segmentation will be carried out. So this is the overall segmentation process. So here the vein region and the outer boundary region is extracted from the image and the other backgrounds will be eliminated. The ones regions represents the border regions and the vein regions. So here we have to remove the boundary. So after removing the boundary regions, the segmented result is shown in the figure 10. Now the classification is done to display the whether the input person is authenticated or not. After that, the estimation will be carried out. So before the estimation, we have to load the ground truth. This is the ground truth segmentation. This is the predicted segmentation. Now click the button accuracy, Jaccard coefficient, error rate, then sensitivity, Kappa coefficient, Dice coefficient, true positive and true negative. These are the overall estimation to justify whether the input is efficient or not.
Thanks for watching this video.